brought to you by YourQuote, an app that makes you write and perform.
November it was, the onset of autumn loomed around the land of the false Ashoka. To give you some context again, land of the false Ashoka is a nickname used for Cotton College because of the presence of the Ashoka trees. So November it was, the onset of autumn loomed around the land of the false Ashoka. The misery of this ruthless fall engulfed the divine Devodaros in a pale gloom of sorrow, ripping them of the leaves of joy, only to be trampled by feet of grief-stricken souls who had been cursed by this fall alike, neither a rain more nor a storm less. The brides of spring now lay naked, being stripped of their veils green, they now stand in cordons grey, falling prey to winds that betray, molesting their helpless barren ebonies whenever they happen to blow, and yet not a soul ever happened to know. The sapphires that once graced their torsos now lay buried in the dust of dejection, maimed and crushed by destiny, ignorant to their wails, the dreams green turned into nightmares pale. I wasn't any different to those trees. It had been ages since autumn decided to fall for me, kissing me with all her despair, it made love with my happiness, and there I stood, wretched and forlorn, waiting for the last kiss of fate on this life tree that would finally set me free from this cycle of deceit, of joy and of fear, of hope and of tear, of nightmares and of dreams, of autumns and of springs. And then I happened to see her, a spring that I so desperately yearned for, a spring that I had heard of in pubs amidst clutters of glasses filled with the desires of the unseen, a spring that I read about in fairy tales written by trails of cigarette smokes, narrating tales of its artistry in euphony. A spring that was more divine than human, which was more of a mirage than an oasis. But there she was, draped in purple, drenched in elegance. She walked in beauty down the caviar like some byron's good night. With sober eyes dark and deep, as if they were the culmination of the desperate desires of some mad Van Gogh, locked up in a cell who would do nothing but paint those eyes and name them the Starry Nights. Even the waves of time seemed to take a pause, as if to allow the waters of the mighty Brahmaputra to steal a glance of the purple spring, so that they would have stories to tell of magic and of divinity, of life and of love. And then she happened to stand beside me, resurrecting the leaves of hope that I had shed long back, and made me dream again of a future devoid of deciduous autumns, and dream of an evergreen perennial spring. And now, as my journey here is about to come to an end, I can again see the autumn in the horizon. As it is time for the purple to turn pale, I can see my spring walk away, for it's time for the cycle of destiny to repeat. I wish I could hold her back and tell how much the spring of her smile means to the autumn that I am. I wish I could ask her to stay by defying the odds of destiny. I wish I could ask this divine spring to drape my life in purple. Thank you.